Yo, 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 what's up, YouTube? Brought you in here today to show you a little bit of my stuff. I mean, let you guys have a look at just what I done did in the RC hobby. Want to send a shout out to Nitro RCX. Want to send a shout out to the Nitro RC Chop Shop. Know what I mean? Good people take care of me. Give me the stuff I need. Keep my race running. Know what I mean? But, yeah, I'll just bring you in today, show you my buggy, show you where he at as of today, currently. There she is, sitting nice. You can see, aluminum everything. I need to get me another aluminum shock, though. Broke it off yesterday. But, it's all good. Get another one of them. She good to go. But I'm gonna show you guys what I've done with this buggy. You know what I mean? And, since I done got into this hobby, I made up my mind I'm gonna roll with Exceed Everything. I mean, as far as if I get a buggy, it's gonna be Exceed Buggy, but I put my own intelligence in and upgrade it and make it better than some of the top of the line stuff, because it's easier to work on, it's easier to get their parts and things like that. But yeah, you can see I got aluminum everything. This buggy, this is my first bug I ever got, first bug I ordered. At first it was green. It was a brush version, came with this motor right here. 540 brush motor. I mean, then I upgraded to this hobby wing. It was okay, but it wasn't the speed I was looking for. But it was cool when I wanted to switch it from brush to brushless. Threw it off in there with the hobby wing ESC, ran there for a little while. You know what I mean? These just backup motors I got for it. You can see the castle, four pole. You know what I mean? 4300. Got that in case I need it. Got one of these TRX sensors, four turn motors. Got one of them if I need. Need here just for some projects I'm gonna have later. Probably put this in a rock crawler. Probably put this in a motorcycle. This right here is a 9000 kV energy motor. Yep, probably get me an electric motor so I can run it in that and there. But back to my buggy here. Need to upgrade my receiver, but for now, I got this axle. It's okay. It's cool. I'm probably gonna get a fly sky or something like that here soon. Anyway, I done changed everything on this buggy, from the wing to the chassis plate. I mean, the shock tower shocks, aluminum arms, hubs, servo. That's the only thing stock on here. But I'll show you what I got in here on this beast. The Traxxas Virginia. You know what I mean? Yep. That's what I got off in this Exceed buggy, Valenian. As you can see, with the Traxxas Valenian motor, 3500. So much power, so much energy coming out of this thing. Torque, man, I guess, because the setup, man. I mean, I think this ESC is rated at 200 amp. And I mean, I'm running it on this here 3-cell, 11.1 volt, Traxxas LiPo. That's what I got off right now, 3-cell. And I'm getting there a bit, I know. Right at 80 miles an hour, I just think. I'm talking about sheer speed, moving, and it handles so good, not with so much performance. I mean, I got the energy fan on it. It don't get hot or nothing. I mean, this the first setup I done run into where I ain't have to worry about temps. Got a metric pinion gear setup off in there, as you can see. That's a 21 tooth. 48 pitch metric, 48-2 spur gear, steel on steel. Best way to go. Energy fan on it. Get the fan on the Valenian. And I got me an Exceed drill style coming that I'm pretty much going to do the same thing to it. Put some on-road tires on it. Take them drift tires off. Aluminum arms. I'm aluminum the plates on both of them too. The whole plate, just a different plate from the one I first got. I had a bad accident and had to reorder another one, but I want an aluminum net out too. And I'm going to do the same thing with the drift style. Aluminum everything. And throw that Traxxas Valenian off in it. Really get some humming out of it. Yep. Running on that 3-cell, 11.1 volt. No, I ain't got to worry about temps. The vehicle pretty light, so it really can push it. I mean, you don't have to worry about it wheeling it up and none being four-wheel drive. Just snatching, just peeling off. It's all they do. Don't burn no rubber. I got them tires taped on the inside, and I seal them up with Gorilla Glue. I'm not pretty good at gluing tires yet, but they getting the job done. They're not ballooning or anything. Got them taped on the inside, like steel belted. Kind of whatever, you know. You know what I'm talking about. Shit. Anyway, this is my baby, you know what I'm saying? I was thinking about getting that Lowski Mini 8, but then I said, nah, man, I'm going to get that drift stuff. And, because I want me an on-road, but I probably get the Lowski sometime, but right now I want the drift stuff. And I want an on-road car. Well, I can pretty much do the same thing to it. And see what I'm getting. Need to give me a radar gun, but I know I'm getting at least 80 miles per hour out of this thing. Easily. But anyway, appreciate you guys. Just bring you in, show you a little bit of what I got, you know, what I'm doing, what I'm trying to do, and hey, maybe I see you out on the road one day. Hit me up, let me know what you think, and appreciate everything, alright? Have a good one.